Dear students of 9A and 9B, here there are some points I have mentioned in the board. I shall teach it the following points. Point number one, meaning of elections. What is the meaning of elections? Election means choice of the people. Which type of choice? Choice for their representatives who would be elected by them for the formation of a government and for the work, for the fulfillment, for their fulfillment, for the fulfillment of their expectations. Now, whatever expectations they expect from their representatives before casting vote in favor of him or before choosing him to be their representative, they would ask them, and the representative assures before election assures before them that he would fulfill their all expectations if he is elected by them. And the election is a process by which all the representatives of the people from different, you know, constituencies of India are elected through the process of direct and indirect method. This is known as election, my dear students. And now, what is the importance of elections? Elections are important because it is a process of a democratic form of government. People can choose their representatives. People keep faith on him by observing him for 5 years, whether the person is able to remove their distress, to solve their problems, to protect them from all difficulties. These 5 years of duration help their representative to be elected for the next 5 years most, next 5 years more by the people if he proves to be efficient, he proves to be skillful, and is able to gain faith of the people. In that case, people rechoice him, once again choose him twice as their representative. And he can start a new role as the representative of the people, as the representative of the people of his own constituency. And next point, kinds of elections in India. In India, there are two types of elections held. Elections are held in India through two processes. Number one, direct, and number two, indirect. These two methods of election, direct and indirect, indirect are held for choosing the representative of both the two houses of parliament by the members of both the two houses of parliament. For example, in the Lok Sabha, members of parliaments are elected directly during general election by the people. That means a general election is held in the country, a general election is held throughout the country for choosing or for electing the members of different constituencies by the people. So, the people elect their representatives and send them to the Lok Sabha as their member. So the members of the Lok Sabha means MP. MPs are elected by the people directly. And their term is about 5 years. Within 5 years, a member can become a member of the Lok Sabha and represent all the and produce all the problems of his own constituency before the ministers. Ministers assure the respective member of parliament that he would solve the problem of his constituency. Another election also is held, that is indirect election. Indirect election is held where people do not have any role. People cannot choose their representative, but only the members of the parliament. So, for example, presidential election, election for the vice president, these are the two elections are held through indirect method. And in that case, people cannot take part in the election, but only the members of the both two houses of the parliament and the members of the legislative assembly, state legislative assembly. But in election for the president, you know, members of the Lok Sabha, members of the Rajya Sabha and members of the state legislatures can take part and can cast their votes. So in presidential elections, members of three organs take part. Members of the Lok Sabha, members of the Rajya Sabha and members of the state legislative assembly. That means MPs of Lok Sabha, MPs of the Rajya Sabha, MPs of the Vidhan Sabha or Legislative Assembly. These three members unitedly cast their votes and choose the President of India. The process by which this election is conducted is indirect method, through indirect method but not through direct method. Similarly, in the case of election for Vice President of India, through indirect method, the election is conducted. But in the election for Vice President of India, only the two members of the Lok Sabha and the House, Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha take part. That means both the members of the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha choose or cast their votes and make one person to be the Vice President of India. But in that case, the members of the State Legislative Assemblies, the members of the State Legislative Assemblies are not entitled to be the voters of the election for Vice President. Only the members of the Lok Sabha and the members of the Rajya Sabha can cast their votes in order to make one person as the Vice President of India, but not the members of the State Legislative Assembly. So, in making a person the President of India or the Vice President of India, the method by which the election is held is indirect, not direct. So what did we understand? We understood that Elections are of two types, direct election and indirect election. Direct election, elections are held by the active participation of the people in the election. People can take part, people can cast their votes and make their representatives to be the members of the parliament, the members of the state legislative assemblies, and ultimately they form the government and they may be the minister and solve their problems. But in the election for the president and vice president, which method of election is conducted? Indirect method of election is conducted. Here, people do not have any role. Next point. So we talked about meaning of election, importance of election, kinds of elections in India. Now, types of elections already I have taught. Now, merits and demerits of direct and indirect elections. Merits and demerits of direct and indirect elections. What are the merits of direct elections? What are the merits of indirect election? Merits of direct election. A large number of people are involved. The chances of intimidation and corruption. Sorry. Are less. And demerits. Demerits of direct election. Illiteracy, poverty and lack of economic awareness renders the people unable to make the correct choice only because of illiteracy. They cannot choose their representatives correctly, and a group of people, especially poor people, sometimes they are won over. Although there is no proof, if there is any proof proved to be correct, the election is declared illegal and a new election, fresh election is held. Anyway, ignorance and innocence voter make them liable to false electoral promises. Now, what are the merits of indirect elections? Less time and expense is involved as the number of voters is less in indirect method. And demerits of indirect election. Individual citizen loses touch with his or her government and is removed from its functioning. The small number of voters become vulnerable to bribes by rich and powerful candidates for his or her vested interest, as I told you earlier. So these are the demerits of the indirect elections. The people elect merit of the direct election. The people elected become answerable and therefore their responsibility increases. And demerits of direct election, illiteracy, poverty and lack of economic awareness enable them to make correct choice. So these are the merits and demerits of direct and indirect elections. In our country, in direct election, all voters choose their representatives directly with all the necessary qualifications, directly choose their representatives. But in indirect election, when the directly elected representatives in turn elect other officials, indirect election, the people cannot take part in the indirect election. Only the members of the parliament are allowed to take part for choosing a person, the president or the vice president of India. Up to this, my dear students. Thank you.